Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Scary Pool Party Fan Club, where we talk about everything Scary Pool Party related. I'm your host, Sarah, and as always, I am super excited to be here, so let's get to it. So today I'm going to review Movie Screens, which was released as a six-track on the Act of Forgiveness on August 27th, 2021. And this is one of my favorite chapters of the saga that is the Act of Forgiveness. And he said about this chapter that this is the chapter where we don't want to see the flaws and we look past the flawed imagination, creating movie-like scenarios around life and not wanting to look at the real picture. I don't know about you, but I have definitely done this in my past. And we kind of grow up with this, you know, predisposition to expect what we see in the movies. Like, love looks a certain way, and hate looks a certain way, and we kind of develop these like judgments about things and people and what romance should be. That's a big one. So I totally get like where he's coming from with this chapter, and I love that he included a song that kind of encapsulates that. I'm gonna play it here and we'll come back afterwards.
Yeah.
So that was the song Movie Screens, and this is a song that we've heard before. It is this like there's grand entrance, and at first I thought it was sounding like the orchestra, but it's not. This was not arranged by Rob Mathis. The producer was Scarypoolparty, associated performer and vocals and guitar was Alejandro Aranda, studio personnel engineer Chandler Harrod, associated performer drums Andy Prado Jr., studio personnel assistant recording engineer Tommy Hessenius, studio personnel engineer Fabian Rubio, studio personnel mixer Manny Marroquin, studio personnel engineer Chris Galland, studio personnel engineer Scott Demaris, studio personnel engineer Jeremie Inhaber, composer and lyricist Alejandro Aranda. So it's a very dramatic with the entrance, and of course Andy on the drums, right? Like he's just such an amazing drummer. And part of this was released as an Instagram clip in 2019, I believe. And there are many, many layers to this song. Admittedly, this is one of my favorite things he does. I love that he layers sound on top of each other. You can have the drums and you can have guitars and basses and synth, and you have all these different layers and piano. So I love it. But the words to the song, which did take me a little bit to figure out, and I actually got some help because I could not hear all the words. But the words are, "You tell me that it's already over. I don't know what I've done. Get in the car and drive over. Get in the car and tell me why. There's something that you'll never realize. I'll buy you flowers in the morning light. Oh. You promised sunny skies. I'll never mean a thing, just like in movie screens. Ooh. You promised sunny skies. I'll never mean a thing, just like in movie screens. I walk you to your car in the morning, stayed up till the sun went down. Call you once again and start over. Parking violations when you leave. I never had the money to succeed. I'm paying out the debt you left me. Ooh. You promised sunny skies. I'll never mean a thing, just like in movie screens. Ooh. You promised sunny skies. I'll never mean a thing, just like in movie screens." Wow, like these lyrics, I love it. And it seems to be like the end of the relationship, or kind of the like rocky end of the relationship, when you kind of, keep trying to talk it out and you keep trying to make it happen and it's just not happening. And you say it's already over, even though it feels like it just started. Like, I love his ability to tell stories. And I think it's one of the best things about his music is that I always feel like I'm hearing a part of his life. And it may not be him specifically, but somebody in his life had this. And it feels very real to me always. And I love the part of these lyrics that said, "There's something that you'll never realize. I'll buy you flowers in the morning light." Oh, I love that line. Like, it echoes like his commitment to the relationship, even though she's not committed to it. And she's saying it's over, and it keeps happening over and over again. And you get that kind of sense that this is like a frustrating thing, but he's in it, even though all this stuff keeps happening. So, and it's kind of playing on that theme that Hollywood builds up this is what it's supposed to be like. You're supposed to buy flowers and, you're supposed to like stay up till the sun goes up and, talk and start over and work on things. And that's what you see in the movies, right? Like, there's a person that's in love with somebody else and they break up, but then they get back together and it's all happy. Except that doesn't really echo real life because, well, I mean, I guess it could for some people, but I just love the entire song. I feel like, this is a song we didn't know was coming. It was an absolute joy when I got the album and heard it. a lot of people recognized that it was an Instagram clip. So yeah, it was just so great. And I mean, we're going to move on because we have lots of songs to cover, and I want to get this one up, and we're going to move on to Beautiful next, which is one of my favorite songs on the albums. Thanks for joining us on the Scary Pool Party Fan Club. If you like this channel, please like and subscribe below to stay tuned for all of our reviews and Scary Pool Party news that comes out. In the meantime, take care of yourselves and take care of each other. Bye!